Hello and welcome back to The New Creationist. Today we're going to be looking at a gene that's mentioned as being evidence for evolution, and we're going to take a close look at the cytochrome C protein, which is encoded by the somatic cytochrome C gene in various species, from most similar to least similar to human, the same as we did with the cytochrome B. What I have here is a table with the various species, human, chimp, gorilla, orangutan, the Sumatran orangutan, gibbon, olive baboon, rhesus macaque, and so forth. And the first thing you're going to notice is for the first five species, human, chimp, gorilla, orangutan, gibbon, that they are 100% identical. Olive baboon has one difference, the rhesus macaque has one difference, Barbary macaque one difference, silver leaf monkey has three differences, as well as the Hamadryas baboon, spider monkey 5, squirrel monkey 8, and marmoset 9. So all these differences. So what we're going to be considering then is, if evolution were true, then with these first five species being identical, that the number of mutations in the gene that would affect the protein chain would occur at an extremely slow rate. So if you have, say for example, 10 million years between a common ancestor for gorilla and human, and yet you have no amino acid differences, let's say the Sumatran orangutan, no differences, and that, you know, I'm not sure, maybe 14 million years supposedly between the common ancestor between orangutan and human, gibbon maybe 20 million years between common ancestor and between gibbon and human, and yet still we see no differences in the amino acid chain. So if evolution were true, then this would be the most highly conserved gene, or one of at least a very highly conserved gene among species. And then of course we see one difference between the baboon and rhesus and Barbary macaque. So even still, with one difference or one mutation that would affect the amino acid chain, then we would expect a very, very slow mutation rate with this gene. Now, as we page down, because what I've done again is I have separated the primates, highlighted in red, and non-primates, highlighted in different colors, mostly tan. We'll just go down and look at some of the mammals. And as we, as we look at the first non-primate that pops up with nine differences, which happens to be the same number of differences as marmoset, is rabbit, also rat and mouse. However, we see with 10 differences, gray mouse lemur, which is a primate, and another lemur, greater galago, tarsier, all with 10 differences. So the idea that the very extremely slow mutation rate, with perhaps only one amino acid affecting mutation in 20 some odd million years or more, and yet we have non-primates like rabbit, rat, and mouse being more similar to human than these primates. And of course, which is in direct contradiction to evolution theory, which would suggest that primates would have a common ancestor more recent than these other non-primates. But that's not all. Let's keep on going. Also notice the equidistance problem. If you're gonna suggest that equidistance is evidence for evolution, then you have 10 differences between quite a variety of species, including kangaroo, gray whale, llama, camel, sheep, pig, cow, tarsier, otto lemur, or galago, lemur, gray mouse lemur, these lemurs. The question, of course, then comes up, why would these be equidistant to human if you're using human as a reference point? How in the world could these be the same? You've got an extremely slow mutation rate, which would suggest that all of these animals would have diverged at the same time. But that seems completely ridiculous if you have primates diverging at the same time as gray whales, or kangaroos, and camels, sheep, and pigs. But that's not all. Let's keep going. Here you got a duck with 11 differences, and two more primates, a slender loris and a slow loris. So you have a duck having the same percent of similarity at 89.52% with 11 differences as two primates. And a duck, being of course a bird, is more similar to human than, or as similar to human as a cat, a dog, a hippo, a donkey, zebra, and more similar to human than an elephant, seal, and a horse, which are both mammals. But we're still not done yet. As we go down, we got pigeon. Okay, now you've got some more birds. So a duck being a bird is separated somewhat from these other birds, only by one amino acid difference. But if you consider the long period of mutation rate at several million years per mutation, then this is significant, where you have pigeon, king penguin, emu, turkey, and ostrich being, well, here you've got 13 differences, pigeon being 12 differences. But we're still not done, because all these then would be equidistant at 13 mutations to an American alligator. And now the shocker, a bush baby, otto lemur garnetti, being less similar to human at 14 differences than an American alligator at only 13 differences. Of course, the question being, why in the world would an alligator be more similar to human than a primate? So, to answer, well, I'm not sure that there is an evolutionary answer to that question, but let's look at some of the data. Here I have the otto lemur garnetti protein sequence compared to human. And I'm going to page down for a second. There we go. We're going to page down to the result information. And here's the comparison, the query sequences, which are straight out of, and these are manually curated sequences through Uniprot. So the identical positions at 91 between human and otto lemur garnetti, and for an alligator, Again, we're going to look at the result information at 92. I'm sorry, 92 identical positions between human and alligator. So 92 identical amino acid positions between human and alligator, and 91 identical positions between human and Autolemur garneti, which is, of course, as I said before, a primate. The question then is, why in the world would an alligator be more similar at 87.62%? Would an alligator be more similar to human than another primate at 86.67%, rounded up, you know? So the evidence here is drastically and ridiculously contradicting the theory. And it just boggles my mind how anyone could present cytochrome C as evidence for evolution in light of this evidence. Thank you very much, and until next time, God bless.